So one of the things I want to speak about is the importance of the youth in Islam. Youth in Islamic terminology is anything or anyone under the age of 40. So anyone under the age of 40. So you, my dear brothers, those who are considered to be youth, yous are honored or yous have a high degree in Islam. You would see that throughout the time, even with the previous prophets up until our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the youth, they played the role in this deen. This is when, if we know the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he broke the idols, he was at this age. So the age of 13, 12, 13, 14, he was very young when this took place. This is Ibrahim alayhi salam. We know that also the people of the cave, the people of the cave were youth, like yourselves, but they wanted to keep away and be away from all the evil that was and the corruption that was happening in their town. So they withdrew and they went into the cave, and we know further of the story of the people of Al-Kahf. Also, we have the youth within Islam at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. There was two youth in the battle of Badr and of the killing of Abu Jahl. What happened? There was a man who was standing, a Sahabi, he was standing, in the story is as narrated. He was standing and he is getting ready for this battle. And during this battle, he notices that there is a child to his right, or a youth to his right, and a youth to his left. So usually in a battle, you want somebody standing next to you who is strong and powerful, like you can have each other's back, so to speak. So this man, he starts to worry. And he looks at this one, and he's a youth, and he looks at this one, he's a youth, and he starts to worry a bit. If things get really hot, what are these two going to do? So one of them turns to him and he says, Oh uncle, which one here is Abu Jahl? So he says, he's thinking to himself, why does this kid want to know who Abu Jahl is? And he says to him, why do you want to know who Abu Jahl is? He says, because we heard of what he used to say about the Prophet ﷺ, and I want to kill him. So at this point, this Sahabi is thinking, mashallah, this youth is, you know, he's got some courage. All of a sudden he's poked from the other side. Oh uncle. He looks to the other one. Yes, which one is Abu Jahl? Which one? Show me who is Abu Jahl. Why? Same thing. Because I've heard of what he has said and done to the Muslims and said about Islam, about the Prophet, and I want to kill him. So over here now, this Sahabi who is a man, he feels better about himself knowing that he has what? Two lions next to him. So the battle takes place. And Abu Jahl is killed, and they say that the last two strikes is from these two boys. And each one of these two boys, they're arguing, saying, I have killed the enemy of Allah. I killed the Fir'aun of this ummah. I have killed the worst enemy of Islam. So they were arguing between themselves. And they went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they said, O Prophet of Allah, I killed him. And he's saying, I killed him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he judged between them. Point here, what were they? Youth. Later, after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, towards the end of his time, he appoints a leader of the army, Usama bin Zayd. Also, at what age was he? 20, 21, 30, 40, 50, 60? No, 14, 15, 16 years old. A leader of the army. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dies. Abu Bakr is now the leader of the Muslims. And the other Sahabi, they're starting to worry, how can we have a youth lead the army? And within this army is the old and great Sahabi. So they approach Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and they say to him, remove him, replace him. And he said, how can I replace someone in which the Prophet ﷺ gave a position to? So he led an army at the age of 14, 15, 16 years old. Where are our youth today? Where are our youth today? And this is not taking a shot at the youth. Wallahi, I understand, and we all understand what it's like to be a youth living in Sydney. I personally am from this area. I grew up here. I was born here. I was raised here. I hung out here. I've seen friends die here. I've seen friends go to jail here. I've seen friends lead the worst of lives. And then I've also seen those who live the worst of lives coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I know what you're feeling. So don't say, who's this guy? He doesn't know what he's going on about. Just like you were sitting here, I was sitting there one day too. But we need the youth to take a role in Islam, just like the youth at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, as we say this to the youth, we cannot forget we have shaitan on the other side. We have those who are following the way of the righteous predecessors, the way of the prophets, who are calling you to Jannah. And then you have shaitan and his henchmen and his soldiers calling you to the hellfire. So there's a battle going on, my dear brothers. So you are either with the camp of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you're with the camp of a shaitan. May Allah azza wa jal curse him.